if you think that the infamous Chernobyl nuclear power plant produced, pun intended, only the A1 accident, the one that we all know it from, you are wrong. To be totally honest, it's not exclusively Chernobyl thing to host different accidents over the years. But I was pretty much shocked when I learned that before this famous huge one, the power plant had more of them, and not years apart. Because there were several very risky situations in less than 4 years before the reactor number 4 catastrophe. This video you are watching now marks the start of another miniseries inside our larger project, which is Chernobyl Stories. We will tell you not only about particular accidents like today, but also about the history of the whole Chernobyl nuclear power plant, about its construction, about the project, about the people behind it, about the disaster itself, of course, but also about what happened to it shortly after and years later. So as not to keep you all waiting, let's start today's subject. Chernobyl Nuclear Power Plant History, Part 1. Chernobyl Accidents. Bit of a basic historical background for the first one. The infamous power plant construction started in the 1970s. The plan was kind of modular. The need for a stable power supply was high, so instead of building all at once for a long time, they decided to finish the reactor buildings one by one. This was planned so the power plant could start working as soon as possible. Thus, when the first reactor building was commissioned in 1977, the other ones were still under construction or at least not yet officially commissioned. Of course, it was all being done simultaneously. The official start was not the first day when any reactor worked. There needed to be a lot of testing and preparations. So when the first reactor was commissioned, that meant his whole structure, personnel, procedures were already operational and tested. There wasn't much time between the completion and formal commissioning of the reactor. That happened on September 26, 1977, and at the same time, other reactors were either being tested, prepared to be turned on, or in the process of having their buildings built. Chernobyl nuclear power plant was supposed to have 6 operational reactors, and when the fatal night of April 26, 1986 came, the infamous reactor number 4 was being tested, but it has started working in 1983, so 3 years before. 3 previous ones were already working, and 2 more reactors had their units being built. These 2 last ones, reactor buildings number 5 and 6, were never finished though. And yes, they are still haunting the exclusion zone in their half-ready state. So that's it with the basics. Since you already know that the first reactor was officially operational in 1987, you could be pretty surprised the first accident happened less than 5 years after that. On September 9th, 1982, there were some really tense moments in the Chernobyl nuclear power plant. I think this should give the power plant management a big warning, but unfortunately it didn't. Reactor number 1 was working for less than a full 5 years when a partial core meltdown happened. The reason was incredibly simple. A faulty cooling valve remained closed following maintenance. When the operators turned the reactor on as planned, the closed valve caused a real problem. Because there wasn't enough cooling, the uranium in the tank overheated and ruptured it. And believe me, you wouldn't like this happening if you were responsible for keeping the power plant safe. However, this could cause a real threat to the whole facility. Fortunately, the rupture was pretty minor. Nobody died because of this accident, well, at least nobody that we know of, but this showed a more concerning problem. Operators didn't realize for hours that there was a trouble with the reactor, probably due to their own negligence. This caused the release of high doses of radiation, but, fortunately again, not enough to pose an international threat. This was significant because of another reason. The accident was classified. Besides a small number of people, no one really knew about it until years later. Despite there being a lot of cleanups taking place, both in the nearby town of Pripyat and around the power plant itself. Shortly after, they simply repaired the reactor and continued to use it again. So what I see here is a pattern, a very dangerous pattern. Something in a nuclear facility breaks down, because of many different precautions and procedures being neglected or not being done as thoroughly as should be done. And then the officials hide the whole accident, even despite active works that are not standard being done. The Ukrainian government revealed classified KGB documents on the 35th Chernobyl disaster anniversary. Thanks to them, we now know the 1982 accident resulted in mentioned radiation release. Of course, the reason behind this cover-up was to prevent panic and provocative rumors. Yeah. Honestly, when I learned about this, I really wondered if the 1986 disaster was not possible to prevent. Especially the leaders of the USSR received a warning 3 years before that. From the mentioned documents, we can see that Moscow was told that, quoting, "The Chernobyl nuclear power plant was one of the most dangerous nuclear power plants in the whole USSR due to lack of the safety equipment." But that's not even all. 2 years before the fatal night, there were two more accidents. One occurred in the reactor number 3 and the second one in the reactor number 4. However, we don't know precisely what happened and why. We have some hints. These were probably significant ones, but we kind of have to read between the lines here. The KGB was very active regarding the power plant and all people visiting it, especially if they were Westerners. But look, in 1987, a French journalist picked up some soil samples when he was in the zone. Pretty insignificant thing, right? Just some earth. What could be dangerous here for the mighty USSR? And here comes the KGB. They switched his samples for the fake ones. Why did they do it? Well, my guess would be simple. These samples could hold some traces of previous accidents that happened in the Chernobyl power plant. If that was the case, they could be used to at least ask some tough questions like, "Hey, if there were serious accidents before 1986, could that disaster be avoided?" I think we all know the answer. However, I don't believe anybody can tell with 100% certainty that this could be prevented. The previous accidents should point to the USSR's focus on guaranteeing the safety of its own nuclear energy strategy. But it obviously didn't, and the USSR leaders were probably furiously obsessed with covering that up. You know, so nobody could point his finger at them and told them, "You f***ed that up." Well, I hope you learned something new today and that you liked this video. As I said at the beginning, these last videos we have published over the past months are just a mere start of a larger project designed for years. We want to share our knowledge and also show you what we have seen, how we felt, and what we think of the whole Chernobyl disaster. So, please guys, keep an eye on new videos in our Chernobyl Stories project and watch the previous ones if you haven't seen them yet. That's all for today. Stay safe and see you next week.